Hello everyone. I actually had started this design demonstration and I realized I was doing the wrong band, the wrong technique, which is a technique I'm actually working on for my next design. But anyhow, I came up with this design and it reminded me of those lizards that have the little floppy things on the side. So I looked up what type of lizard it is, and it is, where are you? Come on, mine. Hold on, everybody. It is a native of Australia called the frilled lizard or frilled dragon. So yeah, isn't that cool looking? Kind of a little reminiscent, huh? So I'm calling this design the Frilly Dragon. So that's this one. And I made this one. And this was the original. I just started out putting bands and beads and stuff. And I finally came to this right here. I said, ooh, that pretty. Now this one I alternated the colors. So if you're going to do an alternate color pattern like this, you'll definitely want the, I use a double strand of one and then a single strand of another color. And minimal six lengths for the double strand. See that was double, this was single, and I tied them together. Okay, yeah, I did that in the first part demonstration, which I have to erase because I messed up. So let me show you. For my smaller wrist and for 11 bead sections, if you use six, my lengths, I use like the long side of this loom. This is what you're going to have left. So if you got a larger wrist, you might want to go 6.5, maybe even 7 lengths. But if you're not going to alternate colors, if you're just going to keep, like this one has the pink, which just kind of peaks up there. This one has the black, which just barely peaks through. 4 lengths is more than enough. As you can see, the 4 loom lengths will give you plenty of leftover. So if you know, if you're just going to do it all solid color, don't waste. So you're going to have one strand. This one strand was like this. 1, 2, 3, 4 lengths, okay? And this, I've already split it apart, but come on. The other one was like, you know, pretend this was all like this. You know, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6.5 to 7 lengths, okay? So then you bring them together. It's like, see, in this one, because I'm not going to be alternating colors, the single strand of the white is much shorter than the blue. And these are bands that I got compliments of Sandy at Lila's Gigi, at Lila's Gigi on Instagram. I wouldn't have been able to make this one right now because I didn't have enough length of the dark blue, which is my absolute favorite color. So now you're going to place it like this, and you're going to, you know, make sure you have them all, your what was double here, you know, pull them apart, and you're going to divide these into two sections, okay, like this. So to start out, you're going to take one of each color. And I don't know if it matters if it's on the inside or the outside, but mine's just going on the outside, so, you know, the white part. So you're going to tuck that in, right? And, oh, I just looked online for what knot this is. I forget. Oh my goodness. Anyways, it's a real simple one. So you're going to make like the number 4, when you're on this side of the loom. Bring it under these, but over that. And the trick to this is even tension. Just enough so it's snug, not loose, but don't yank it tight either. And you're going to do 6 of these. And if, you know, if you make a section and it looks sloppy, just unravel it and start over again. It's, you know, it's very easy to undo and redo. And, it, you know, it's kind of like crocheting or knitting, I imagine. You get better at practice. So that was 3. 4. How many did I do? I think it was 5. Oh, yeah, 5. 5. X, my notes. Okay. Now, this particular loop, it says online that if you keep doing it, it starts kind of making a spiral pattern. So at 5 knots, it almost, see, it's starting to want to go over. So you got that there. Oh, yeah, I didn't show you on this one. I'm using these, and this is the center one. And I'll show you how to put those together afterwards. So now we'll do the same thing on this side. So you're going to take these 2. Just make them so they're not slack. You don't want to stretch it overstretch it. So now this one's going to be like a backwards 4 over these 2. Then bring the end up right through this. And then just... Oh, it's raining in Southern California. Hallelujah. So we're going to do that 5 times. Super, super, super easy design. The only difficulty is the tension right here. See, just enough for it to be, to hold its shape. Like, let's see. Like, you know, that's kind of, see how it's loose right there? So you just want to, just so it holds itself. You don't want to do it too tight or it's messy. And try to also go like this because, like I said, you start doing enough of these loops in an order, it starts spiraling. But the 5 seems to work just enough. So once you put the bead in, okay, my phone is ringing. I'll be right back. Ah, that was my husband. He had texted me first. Now my phone's gonna keep reminding me that I didn't answer his text. He just called for a grocery order. Isn't he sweet? Okay, now you're gonna want beads that you can fit all 6 of these bands. So on these, I had them facing this way. So to do that, I'm not actually going to do that on this design, but in case you want to do them like this, I will show you. And these here, these are 4 rings I just kind of put together and then alternated with this one, and I really liked how that looked. Okay, so you're going to take these 3 and feed them that way. Okay, then you're going to take these 3. I'll be right back. Okay, sorry about that. Just another grocery question. So, if your hole's big enough, you can just feed all 3 of these through, either 1 at a time, 2 at a time. You know, or you can take something like, you know, how we pull beads through. You can do that, right? Grab either 1 at a time or all 3, depending on the size of your bead hole. Probably easier if they're all the same length. But anyhow, the end goal is to do this. Okay. So you grab each 3-end. Like that. And then you're going to do the 5 and the 5 over and over again. So 5 on this side, 5 on this side, add a bead. But for me, I want to try something different. Which I might go back to the way I had it, but I want to try this. I'm going to put them all down from the same side instead of opposing sides. See what happens. On the air experiment, what do you think? I'm sure it'll look fine. Now, this first section is going to be a little funky, but not to worry. It's under the wrist, so you don't really see it. Okay. Now, what you want to do is, because if you keep using the same end to wrap, one's going to be real short. So every other time you do this, one of your double color is going to be longer. So you're going to hold, that's the one you're going to be wrapping. So here's the long one, okay, right here. Put it off to the side and put the shorter end in the single color like this. And do one. Two. Three, four. And if you kind of go like that, it helps keeping it from wanting to spiral as much. That's five. So then we do this side, find the long one, untangle it, put it off to the side. Grab these two and make it taut, just like that. Not super stretched, but just no slack either. Then you'll do the same thing on this side. One. Oh, Juju. Two. Doggy and kitty want to play. Or doggy wants to play and kitty doesn't. Two, three, four, and five. The center's all stretched out. You're trying to get closer to kitty, but He learned really quickly. The very day we got him, when he was 12 weeks old, he got himself a little bloody nose by sniffing the kitty too closely. Actually, we have two kitties. So, yeah. Okay, so now I'm just hoping that design holds its shape by putting them all this way instead of the way I originally demonstrated. If not, I'll just pull it apart and start all over again. I'll probably know after I do a couple of these. Yeah, I'm not liking that. It's not holding its shape. So you get to see me do this over again. I'll demonstrate how to unravel it if you don't like what you're doing. So, actually, it's easy to take it off to do this part. So this is all you do, just real simple. It's just a little pain when it's all the strands are long. So anyways, I'm going to go off camera and do this. And then I'm not going to take this one apart, just this. And then you can watch me demonstrate it a little bit more so that you make sure you have the hang of it.
Okay,
sorry about that. Rewind. So now we're back. I did the first five loops. And I'm going to feed these through the original way because it just works better. Three this way. And if you have to feed them one at a time or used, you know, where that thingy go? Well, you already saw me do it, so. Okay, so you find a little messy right start because it's so long. One, two, three. Okay. So now you got the three that are, you know, from each like that. And you're just going to put them up till they're all the right length. Okay, and this first section, I do, I must say, I have a little trouble getting neat. But I figure that's under the wrist, you don't see it. Okay, so as I said, now you're going to want to find the longest. Kind of get it untwisted here. So it's kind of on the outside of them all. So kind of get that over like that. Put these two like this. And actually, I just remembered something here. Okay, let's do this. Let's see. Just like to try to get it so that that longer one is,
you make it so it's kind of at the top,
not all twisted around these two. Okay, so what we're going to do is put these like this, right? And we're going to do one on this side, right? It's kind of like the locking stitch, the locking knot. And then do one on the other side. Okay, so now you have one on each side. So now you make on this side, it looks like a four. Go under these two, bring it up. So that's the second one. Third. Just snug enough so it holds its shape. Is that four? Four. And keep count. And five. Okay. And I've already done one over there, so I'm going to do four more. One. Silly puppy. Three. Four. Like, if you see it kind of loose or just wanting to come apart like that, that means you haven't done it quite tight enough. So just enough so it kind of, it stays. Okay. So now, we will take another bead. See, now this time, the blues are the same color, are the same length, so it doesn't really matter which one you use. But every other time you pull the bead, one of the double color will be longer. So just keep that in mind. That way you won't run out. I guess, yeah. So you know, you don't want to be shorted on one of the bands before you, one of the strands before you get the design done. And that's all there is to this design. It's really, really easy. The Frilly Dragon. It's cousin to Puff, the Magic Dragon. I have no idea they're related. Just know that one was created by God and the other was created by the mind. Probably somebody on drugs in the 60s, right? Peter, Paul, and Mary? I don't know. I always thought it was a cute little kid song till I grew up and my husband or somebody tried to explain to me that I don't know that was exactly what the song was about. It was. They were making a kid's song, but there's probably some hippie undertones. Okay, so now we've gotten that put on. I'm going to put the two here and two here. They're, my blues are both the same length, so it doesn't matter. Just this, whoops, this, the one that's mostly the top, leave that out and use the two that are closest to the center. It just makes a neater design. Okay. So, we're going to do one on each side to just kind of lock it in and keep it even. And then do four on each, four more on each side. One, two, three, as you can see it's trying to do its little spiral there. So that's five total, so we already done one. The best way to keep it from spiraling is trying to pull it that way against, because it wants to spiral that way. It's two. Three. See, as I'm doing that, it's keeping this over here instead of up like that. And five. See the little frilly, the frill dragon, the cider. Settle down, you silly puppy. You silly puppy. He's being crazy, silly puppy. He wants to play with his rope. Okay, so I'm going to put one more bead through and get you started on the next series of knots, but I mean, that's all you do until you're done, and then you take it, tie it off, and add your whatever clasp. So, three go on that side, and the other three go through on this side. So, what I'm going to do is, since it's my length is 11 beads. I'm doing five of these, this one in the middle, and then five more. So that's how this is designed. It's kind of patriotic. Okay. So now see, on this one, this one's the longer one. So just play around. So that one is, so it looks like that. This one's up. And put this one like that. Find the longer one over here. so it's the top band. And what you want to do to keep the design even, see, if I just did that right now, that's kind of crooked. So just to keep it even, I just try to make it so that it's as straight as possible without one being more taut than the other. And so, one on each side to lock the bead in place. And four more, very simply. On this side, you'll make like you're making a four or a backwards P. Go under these two and then bring the end up through that circle. That's two, and bring it, pull it down a little bit towards that way to help it from not wanting to spiral. Cider, you're being a cute distraction. Yes, you are. Oh, you almost got it in half. You know those doggy ropes with huge knots? That little dog just shreds them into nothingness. First, he breaks. It was a knot, rope, knot. So now it's two knots. One in his silly mouth, he looks foolish. Cider, where are you? Ah, never mind. Anyhow, he's being cute and distracting me. Okay, so let's just finish up here. So that was one. Okay, you can see right here. See how this is up, straight up? It's because it's wanting to start its spiral. So do your best to pull it that way, but not any tighter, just that it's just about the direction. Three. See right there how it just wants to go that way? And it's nothing wrong with it. It's just that if you want these to look a little neater, try to tug it that way. Okay, I'm getting off camera. I'm almost done. Okay, so that's it. Okay, five loops. Put a bead. Five more loops on each side. Put a bead. That's it. The frilly dragon. Cute, I think. I don't know which side I like better. I think this was the back side and this was top side. And you can see I don't have it perfect. You can just kind of play it around with your fingers to get it straightened out. And of course, whenever I put it on Instagram, it'll be whatever segment's the neatest, like we hold to. And then there's this one where I alternated. I put four beads and one big bead, four beads. And this was the one. Okay, I should have told you. Let me explain right here. Okay. If you want to alternate colors, I said make all the lengths the same. And so, obviously, if you want to alternate the colors, you're going to take this one. Of course, I have to put a bead first, but you provide to have the bead first, then you're going to put these two and wrap this one, and that'll make the white on the outside. Whoops. Okay, does that make sense? So, if you want to alternate colors, every other time, the white is going to be on the outside. But I'm keeping it all this, like this. Alrighty. Hopefully that's not too confusing. So whatever color is doing the looping is the color, obviously, that's going to be on the outside because you're wrapping around whatever two bands are right here. Okay? Well, thanks for watching. Feel free to subscribe to Deb's Thing here on YouTube. And, of course, check me out on Instagram at Deb's Thing and give me a follow. I would love it, but you don't have to. Good night.